Hello there, guys, and I'm still beta testing that new intro. That actually, that's the first time I've ever used it. I've just been, kind of thinking about changing some stuff. Well, okay, look, this is a ship that I am in creative on. I should probably turn the hood on, not with the F1 key, but rather with tab, because F1 is Minecraft. So, this is a ship. This is a ship that you know very well. I think you know, will recognize this ship over here. Which, no, that's not it. Where is it? There's got to be one of them around here somewhere still. As you can see, I've been doing some ship changing. This looks like, okay, well, this is ours with its hands taken off. So this ship was never quite what I wanted it to be, but it was also, you know, almost what I wanted it to be. And given that Space Engineers is, by the way, I think you already know, completely changed, or, well, you know, visually changed a lot, I figured that it was time to just correct the problems that I left on this ship. So here they are. The main problem was that this thing here, you know, cockpit, doesn't connect to the cargo container, which means I couldn't use build mode, which was kind of a big deal because that's what I wanted to do with this ship. So I've just taken a second to kind of try and correct that. The reason we're starting in creative is because I wanted to show you this ship. I wanted to, you know, because I've accidentally built it without showing anyone anything, without doing anything. So, I mean, I can at least show you the progression here. Differences, I'll just tell you, are firstly that this cockpit is upside down. So if I show you the plan of the ship, let me just move it. Bit weird to move like this. But if I show you the plan of the ship from the outside by just changing my perspective, it now looks like this. This isn't the front of the ship. The front of the ship is here, which I can't show you the outside camera. What? It's controlling another ship. I actually didn't expect this. There we go. Now I'm controlling the right ship. I really don't know what happened there. I didn't know that was possible, but apparently it is. So, this ship, I've done it like this now so that I can... Firstly, I didn't know the cameras had been improved so much, and I really like that I can now do this, and it actually seems to be, you know, vaguely effective. I wanted to be able to use build mode when I'm in the ship, because that was a big part of why I built the ship. So now, this cockpit, the actual cockpit, this one here, is connected to the rest of the stuff, so that I can actually have, you know, a functioning ship for that. But when I want to actually fly around or use the arms, it's just important that I switch to the camera view. And that's all, basically. That's the major change. And now to go over what else has changed, really, just to take you over to this ship, and we can sort of see the progress. Where's the base of this ship? I don't really keep things organized when I design. This is the base of this ship. This is how this ship started out, with the problem of needing to connect the cockpit to the cargo container, and the fact that cargo containers only have three connections. One here, and then one here. Three connections that are large, which allows all components to pass, which is what I need for the cockpit to be used for build mode. But I also need somewhere to plug in the connector so that I can actually have components put into this ship, and I needed somewhere to have the oxygen plugged in, because the oxygen was also an important part of this. So, what I've done in the end is added this little extension thing here, turned the cockpit upside down, and then I built out the rest of the ship. I was able to use my other ship to push this stuff together and use the welding plates, which are fantastic, I think was the word I was trying to go for, to stick the arms on, which worked out actually extremely well. And now we end up with the ship over here. This one? No, I moved it. This guy here, yeah. Which I'm actually a lot happier with. It kind of works a lot more like the way I really wanted it to. So there we go. I just wanted you to see that. The only real difference between this ship over here and this ship is this probably has less batteries. Still some batteries, but less. Less speed. It's a lot less agile, which is fine. It didn't really need to ever be agile. The agility was only really for my sake. It really just needs to be able to move about. I expect it'll be extremely slow in moving when it's filled, but that's okay. That's not going to be a problem. Well, probably will be a problem, and I'll try and figure out a solution to fix it. But, you know, it's got oxygen, it's got electricity, it's got two weldy, grindy things. So, let's get back to our actual game, now that this is explained, and this will be put in at some point, because sometimes I can build, but not film at the same time, so this will be put in while I'm able to build, but not while I'm able to film. So you'll see this ship coming back into our game in a little while, but for now, it's just going to stay here. But I will need to make some changes to this in the actual video, so we will see this guy in a second, and for now, I will see you in a second in our actual, you know, Space Engineers game. Okay, this is our station. This, actually, I haven't really seen it since I came in a little while to do some stuff. I let this build itself, and then I haven't really been back since. I might just have a little tour, given that there was that new pretty amazing update a little while ago, actually several months ago now, I think, and I haven't really seen it since. I think I'll just have a look around, because a lot of this stuff looks a lot cooler with the new update. Like, I love this kind of looks like lockers, which is interesting, but I love the new update anyway. I love the quality of the of everything now. It looks so much cooler. But I realize now my plan for being able to access these didn't work. You can't actually get into the reactors anymore through windows. I'm not used to the mag boots. I'm very unused to the magnetic boots, which really shouldn't work on glass, actually, in my opinion. How do I turn these off? Give me a second to figure this one out. Okay, if your jetpack's not on, or if you're not in gravity, that's where they're automatic. Okay, good. Well, I mean, that's kind of cool. Anyway, I was saying that I really like these new textures and stuff. Very cool, this mag boot stuff. Oh, I will just say very quickly, I am very sorry we haven't had an episode of Space Engineers in a while. I actually started on working on a very cool idea I had for Minecraft, and the longer I went on with it, the harder it got, and then the game eventually broke, and now I can no longer publish that, or at least for now, until I fix the problem, I can't publish it. I'm just giving you a little tour. So that this basically has been my whole 2 months, and then there was the whole, you know, Christmas happening in the middle, very unfortunately timed. Well, we haven't had an episode in a while, but let's just move on. So, our spaceship that we built, the new miner, is here, fully constructed, fully doing its job. Well, not doing its job, it's not actually mining anything, but now we can see the size comparison. It's funny that this one is so much smaller and has so many more drills, and probably would be more effective at getting a lot of resources at once. But this one is much bigger, much more storage, much more powerful. The only thing it misses really is, firstly, I remembered that I forgot to add a jump drive, which is very unfortunate. And I didn't add also a beacon to allow nanites to do this, to build it for me. So I'll just take the one off the other ship and just stick it on here quickly. And then I didn't add a small ship with a small ship jump drive to allow me to conveniently jump between my base and here. So that's two things I need to add. But it's nice being able to see it with a new update. Some of this stuff looks okay, because obviously not all of this stuff has been updated. Some of it was, some of it is modded, and therefore it's not been updated with all the new textures. But this stuff, these kind of like sketchy looking platforms, all kind of actually fit, which is nice. The ship looks pretty cool, a lot cooler in fact than it originally. Well, that was really incredibly stupid. Well, that was weird. I accidentally respawned myself on a planet, which was a little bit disconcerting. Let's go get my stuff back. Fortunately, I can now respawn on this ship, apart from that the med room still needs some repair and hasn't been repaired because I haven't built the beacon on here yet, so we'll just do that now quickly. But this ship is all up and working. I had to move the cockpit a little bit because it turned out to be impossible to steer, so the cockpit is now here, which kind of defeats the point of having a remote control block in this thing, because I was kind of hoping to steer it one way and then when it starts mining to look at it from the other direction, if that makes sense. But oh well, it's a lot easier to drive like this, which I like. So let's just grab my stuff, which is what I forgot to do. It's probably already been taken. I had to grind out this med bay just for a second to install this properly because I was too lazy to go and get the components. So I'm just going to get my stuff back, like I said, and then couldn't find it because it's been picked up already by the nanites. What the hell was that? Everyone heard that explosion, right? What exploded? Is it in the ship? Because that would be really bad. I'm just going to make sure nothing's broken. Okay, well, anyway, I don't know what caused that, but it was weird. Let me go over here, and what I did was, while I was off camera, I've just gone ahead and set these guys to produce a little bit of resources, which is a relief because I just search, which is a relief because I've spent so long not having the right equipment. So there you go, we've got all of this stuff. I also got rid of all the built-up and useless parts that we had. So now, I don't know why I took two of those. So now we should be a little bit better off in that respect. And I'm also going to take an oxygen canister, although I haven't built any oxygen production stuff. I did have it over there, but I had to take it out. Now, I'm just going to grind this off because it doesn't need to be connected anymore. And it's faster than going in the ship and deconnecting it. And then I'm going to take off its repair beacon, which should be somewhere around here. I remember hiding it. Should be off in a little hole somewhere. Ah, there it is. I knew I'd hidden it somewhere. So I'm going to take this. There we go. Not a very efficient process, given that the nanites kept trying to build it back up for me. And then I'm going to go ahead and rebuild it over here, because this ship deserves it a lot more than the other one. I think I can just shove this somewhere. Well, I guess I'll just hide this here and weld it back up myself. There we go. And now I can do the other thing that I need to do to this ship, which is add a jump drive, because it doesn't have one. So let's go find a place inside. Now, where in here, because it's kind of packed, can we shove a whatever I'm trying to build? And also, what plates does it need? So I need steel plates. That's fine, I can get steel plates. There we go. I think maybe there's a little bit of space in between these things. No, Okay. Thing is, I didn't really plan for adding anything else into this bloody place. It's not really designed for that. It's designed for exactly what I designed it for, which was, I think, drilling. Maybe on the back door. Maybe if I take out the back door, which I think would be not a sensible idea, I can shove it in there. Shove it in the back door. Yeah, I can grind out the back and then shove this in. Let's do it now. Just wait for all this crap to get picked up and then we're good. Yeah, so I built myself. I keep getting kind of distracted today because I'm kind of excited to be back in Space Engineers. I built myself some better tools because I figured we had the resources now and that was all we were ever really waiting on. So I've got better tools, which is really nice because I now grind and weld at appropriate speeds. I should be able to actually just chuck all this stuff inside. No, I can't because I haven't got access to any of the boxes. Maybe underneath. That'll work. Hang on. Let me just chuck all this stuff. There we go. I like to imagine my engineer like trying to slide all of these things in through that small gap. Don't send off your grinder. Like he's on his side with his arm trying to get in there so he can just randomly chuck very expensive and very hard to make components into like a tiny hole just so that he can build a jump drive. There we go. That's all the last components. So, what am I missing? What am I missing? Oh, I need to take these off too. First thing we're actually doing with this ship is just taking it apart, which wasn't really what I planned. Yeah, let's put it like that. It works, so why not? And then I'm just going to, since we're here, I'm going to block up the back bit a little bit just to give it some more smoothness. Because it was kind of, I like the way this ship was designed. So I'm going to make sure it stays roughly in the same theme. There we go. That'll just smooth it out a little bit. Be a little bit nicer. They should be black though. I mean, I don't think black should be the color of this ship. I wasn't really planning on ever making it black. But it did end up like this, so why not? There you go. They should all be brown when they spawn now. And this ship needs a deconstruction beacon. Because however good this ship is, we don't need it anymore. And I could use the resources more than I could use the bloody ship. I'm going to go take apart my radio tower for a second just so that I can get this deconstructed. There we go. I actually didn't realize there was a radio tower there that I could have just taken apart, but oh well. There we go. Now, something I should probably do is find the cockpit and convert this to a station just so that I'm not going to have stuff floating everywhere. Probably need to do that before it starts getting taken apart, really. There we go. I think I can do this. There we go. Much better. Now this will be taken apart, which is good because we don't really need it. So, this ship, now that I've fixed it, is not going to do anything. I'm just going to leave it there because what I want to get started on today, I just needed to do that so that it was working. Let me get rid of my body location there. Kind of embarrassing. There we go. Is turn off these because they annoy me. And then we're going to get started on this area, this bay area. So, what this needs is a ton of blocks. I don't think I'm ever going to close off the front. I was thinking about putting a door on, but it seems like that would not be productive. It seems like it'd be too much effort and not really much gain to make this, to give a door here. So, what I'm going to do is just first smooth out this area. Now, I'm going to cut through most of this because it's going to be long and arduous. But once we've smoothed out this area, I can start using it to build ships. Once we've like made this useful, I can start using it. So, it also needs gravity in this area. There you go, just pilfered some plates. Let's get started. Now, this area, what it needs to be, is where I can build all of my ships, where I can spend time. You know, I have access to all the resources I need. Everything's being built properly for me by the nanites, and they're not too far away, so it won't take much longer. That's what this place needs to be. If I can get this bloody place correctly. I think it's the rock that was giving me a hard time. So yeah, I want to have an area where I can just build ships in survival and have everything done for me, like creative, which is really what I like about building in creative and why I find it so much easier. So I'm going to make this place sort of kitted out for that with that purpose in mind. But for now, I just need to get this smoothed out. So I will finish this and then I will see you in just a second. So here we are in what is a slightly modified shipping building area, small ship building area. Didn't really go as I planned, and I actually rather like, I'm going to turn my light off. I actually rather like it because it's it came out a little bit more organically as I was trying to fill up the space. What I mean is that, you've got to put blocks in places, otherwise it's just a rock. So I was putting blocks down, and as I did it, I realized there'd be really a lot of space in this area, way more than I need to build ships. So here is going to be, like, I've put this little, put some rocks there, put this little entrance in, this little door, and I've started airproofing the this area here. So hopefully we should now soon be in a position where we have a little docking bay here, and this is where we will be putting any spaceships. Well, theoretically, in my strange fantasy world, this is where people would come and park their ships and then... oxygen's low, and that's just a little nice touch to add, but I'll show you that when we get there, because right now I'm still building it. I just kind of had to stop myself from going too far and keeping going without like showing you any of the process. I'm still always trying to find that balance between too much block placing on camera and not enough block placing on camera, because you know there's only a certain amount of me putting almost exactly the same block in almost exactly the same place over and over again that people can handle. Or that's what my opinion is. If you feel different about it, let me know and I'll just not edit, and that would save me a lot of time. But otherwise, I've done my best to kind of like cut in halfway through the process. So this floor is going to be a, like I said, docking bay, or some sort of docking bay, at least somewhere to put your ships. This floor is going to be where I will build ships, and what I've done is I've sort of chilled out the rock a little bit here by basically taking this awesome drill thing I made. Well, I didn't make it, I just clicked a button and it made itself, and then just like taking out pieces of rock, and then the most important thing is grabbing these ones. It doesn't matter if I hurt the metal a little bit, just to take out the small bits of rock that are there. By the way, that's what I've been doing, just to clear out the space a little bit here. And then I'm thinking what I'm going to do is, in this space, let me grind out a rough area. In this space here, I'm probably going to build a small, like, ship-building location. What I mean by that is that there's probably going to be a sort of pit here. If you know the starting scenario where you have a platform and there's, like, tools and stuff there, well, they've got a pit of large landing pads, which already attached to them is a small ship block for you to start building from. I want to do something similar to that, but I've got... Basically, the idea is to have... a small ship starting block, which is already powered so that the ship has power before I put reactors on it, and that'll allow me to manipulate things in the ship before I have to decide on where the reactors go and stuff like that. So, I mean, I guess I'll explain that again, like I said, when I get to actually building it, because for now it's just a hole in the floor. And then over here, I've already started this one a little bit, over here is where the wall of components will go, and that is just a wall where I can go and get spare components that I need, and that'll need to, you know, provide everything I could possibly need for placing blocks, and that should really just be a few components, but I'm gonna like maybe put one block for every component just in case. It shouldn't ever be important, because the nanites will do most things. I only need to be able to start the block, then the nanites will do the rest, but I think I'll probably put one in for each component. So last thing, this up here, I started building this this area, and as I put the roof on to make it airtight, I realized how much space there is here, and there really is a lot of space. So what I'm thinking is to make this, I know it's a bit weird, but make it into a bar. Every time I log on to Space Engineers, the first thing that I see right now is a thing in the workshop called benches, and I keep seeing how much cool furniture people make. I know it's not really like engineering, but it's just decorating. But I really want to sort of deck this out to be a lounge. We'll see how that goes, but that's the plan. So I've kind of like double glassed the floor here so that you can't see through quite as clearly. Okay, I know this is stupid, but my genuine concern here was people wearing skirts. Not necessarily men or women, people wearing skirts. Anyone can wear skirts, whatever skirts they want in space. But people wearing skirts and standing on this floor having a drink, and then the pilots below would be able to see up their skirts or... you know, whatever they were wearing, and maybe some alien species don't want people seeing up their skirts. So I've double glassed the glass in order to prevent that. So there you go. Now, the next thing to think about before I start finishing this stuff off is access. And what I'm going to do, I think, is have an elevator. That probably won't work, I'll tell you now. But this is a little pathway. It's a little observation area, and it's going to come right back over here. Oxygen's not doing well. Come right back over here, and I think this is where the elevator will be. Maybe I'll blow a hole in the floor or something. And that's going to take you up to either here, the parking, and then up to here, the whatever this place is, the diner or the bar or whatever it'll be, and then up to, I think, probably either straight to power, either straight to this area, or more likely straight to another area, which I think will go here, which will probably be something to do with some sort of storage, but a very well organized storage, maybe even operations where I can see the quantities of different things, the amount of power going in and out. Like, this is just power storage, and this might be more to do with logistics. Well, I'll build this room when we get there, but the elevator should probably be here anyway. Kind of lost where I was for a second, actually. The elevator should probably be here anyway. So now what I'm going to do is finish off this area so we can talk about it when it's completed. But basically, all you're going to see me doing is suffocating. I'm just going to go ahead and unsuffocate so that I can finish talking to you in dignity. There you go, I'm back and undead. It's a little bit annoying, the whole oxygen thing. I know I've been complaining about it forever, and I have temporarily had different solutions to it, But what I really need to do is sort out some oxygen processing stuff, and that's probably going to be the next thing I do, maybe even today's episode, because every part of the station really should have somewhere where I can access oxygen, because it's a real problem to suddenly die. So I think I'm probably going to have set up some first aid chambers, probably one down here and one upstairs, and well, some in every area that I can feasibly get one into, because there's a lot of free space in this place, as you might have seen. So that's probably going to one of the things I'll do soon. But anyway, I'm going to finish off this wall by putting in all the conduits. I'll probably have to install a system for automatically organizing all this stuff, which there are mods to do that for you, or there are at least scripts that I can set up. And then I think I'll just have to make sure that this place up here is airtight, and then of course start building in the infrastructure to be able to have airtight places, because obviously there is no air, as you just saw with me dying. So let's get going, or get continuing on finishing off this place so that we can move on to bigger and better things. Right, I will see you in just a second when we have finished this place and I've kind of decked it out a little bit. I may even, for the first time in our life, or in our show, this show, colour things, because I've already painted a small section here just for the sake of demarking where the heavy armour blocks and the light armour blocks are. Obviously because ships are supposed to land here, so it's going to take a bit of damage. I may do a bit of painting, because it's kind of dull. Everything's kind of dull, isn't it? It's all grey. Well, I'll have a go at that anyway. So I will see you in a second when this place is a little bit more finished so we can move on to other things. Right, okay, things have been cleaned up a little bit. I'll talk about that bit in a second there. But things are also not finished, because I kind of wanted to cut in halfway through so that people could, or rather you guys, could get a look at what's going on without feeling too much like I've skipped through everything. So here is the same place you saw just a second ago, with a little bit of lag, which is unfortunate. But still basically the same concept. So let's start over here. This is a little sort of control area. God, there's really awful amounts of lag. This is a little control area, and the idea here was, like I said, I think in the previous little section, that this would be where I build small ships. So here I have cargo containers. They're not connected to the system, and they're also not like all built. And this is because, I can show you actually, when I try to build them, like for example, if I put them here, I can very clearly see in the sort of preview thing that the orientation, whereas if I put them on the actual ship, the orientation disappears and I have to just guess. So it's very frustrating to try and put them all in the same alignment, because I want them all like this. They have these lovely like shiny handle things that all should line up, but if I don't put them all in the same the right orientation, they won't line up. So, you know, it's very frustrating, but I will put them all in. It's just that I have to take the time to make sure they're all correctly put in. I think it's just a bug with how the like preview block works. So, well, anyway, other than that, here are some screens that will be working with the LCD script mod thing, where, you know, you can see data from your ship or your station on the LCDs. I'll put these on, and they'll be all different sort of statistics from around this area. I think every area should, like, I should be able to gather the data from every area while I'm in that area, as well as having, I think I'll have a central sort of like logistics place up there. I don't really know what that word means, but a central area with all the data from all of the places over there. So this will look a lot nicer when it's finished, as will all of it. This is the pit that we talked about where, it's not going to be a pit actually, I'm going to fill this hole in, but this is the area we talked about where I'll be using to build small ships, because it's very annoying to have to build a small ship floating in the air. It's even more annoying to not have any power on that ship so you can test its systems while you're building it. So what I want to do here is have a small ship sort of pad, this area, but filled out with small ship blocks, so that when I build a small ship on it, A, it's connected to the station so it has power, and B, it's not going to float away, and C, it's also in this area so I'll be able to go and get any parts I need, rather than like grinding down other things to get the parts, which is equally effective. It's equally as effective as like going and getting the parts myself. It's just that it seems awful, like having to destroy my ship in order to pick up one iron plate so I can keep building seems awful. And I keep saying ship, but it's a station. Otherwise, here is a small sort of observation area that I built. I haven't finished it, I kind of got bored halfway through. I intend this to be airtight, like it's just for looking down here, which you actually can't do very well because it's not set up perfectly. If you go to the very end, you can sort of observe the building of small ships, but it was just to sort of you know, fill out this corner a little bit, and then it will continue over here. We'll have a look at that room in a second. Other things added to this section are this small sort of access port, which is part of the, what are they called? Hang on, I'm gonna cut on them, figure out the name. Maintenance tubes. They are maintenance tubes. They're part of the maintenance tubes mod, which I'm really a big fan of. So I'm gonna try and integrate them into all of my ships. They're a little bit tricky to open sometimes. This one is an airlock because I expect that this area up here will have oxygen. I don't know why they're all red. I really think they should all be yellow or green like this one here. I think I must have set something up wrong, so I mean, we'll see about that. But well, this leads up to the next section, which is the docking bay, which I am incredibly unhappy with, I'll say right now. I spent all this time building it, and I just don't like it at all. I mean, doesn't it just look wrong? Doesn't something about it feel not right? I mean, the idea was that ships would come in here, they'd be able to fly over this section because it's well protected, and then they'd find their bay. So they'd go to this one or one of these, and then they'd just park there. And then the riders, or rather the pilots is what we call it when they pilot a ship, would step out onto here and then continue off and do their stuff over there. But it just looks off. Something about it is not right, and I don't really know what it is. So I think I'm going to keep it like this for as long as I can, and then I'm going to get really frustrated one day and destroy it all and then rebuild it because I'm just not happy with it. So, if we continue off over here, there is a small med bay, also equally unattractive, not happy with it at all, and it will be changed eventually one day. I mean, we can consider this stuff stand-in until I, you know, because it kind of takes me like 3 or 4 times to get to where I want to be. Like the small ship that I'm really happy with, the little baby bird of prey, it's been through like 1,000 iterations before I got to this stage where I'm really happy with it. And even then, I've still made some changes, as you saw at the start of this episode. So this is not permanent, this is going to be like how it will be, and I'll change it as we keep going. Oh, I should show you up here. And this is just like a secondary bay thing for smaller ships if they want to park. Which is equally unattractive. It feels like it was all squished in here. And I think actually that may be the main problem. It feels like the space wasn't very well planned out. So I think we'll be seeing this place disappear in time when I do sort of a rejuvenation of the ship, of the station rather. And then this is supposed to be a little club area, a little area where people can go and relax. It would look better with furniture filling it out, and I will download a furniture mod and fill it out with furniture at some point. But like I said as well, I'm not happy with this place either. For starters, this is uneven. There's this lovely window in the middle. I love this window. I think it's a great feature, and I love how it curves all the way up to the top. But it's one line off. There's like one line of blocks missing here, and it would be perfect. So, I mean, I've designed this so that I can build on here, so that I can, like, put stuff on here. Obviously, I've got no interior plate, but so that I can have, I don't know, seats and bars and stuff like this on this glass. But it's just not an attractive space, so this will be reconsidered. I feel like it just kind of shoved in here. This whole space, I'm not quite happy with it, but, well, it'll probably get changed. And then over here is supposed to be, or will be in the future, because I haven't got around to doing it yet, an elevator. And that will take you all the way up, probably to just before the power plant, probably just before the reactor area, because I don't want a public elevator going to the reactors. It seems odd, so it'll probably take you to around here, which will be another sort of floor. Like I said, and I keep saying, not, oh, I should show you the stairs as well. Like I said, I'm not very happy with any of this area. There's the stairs. These go down back to the main floor, to the main docking bay, I think. Yeah, there they go. So like I said, I'm not happy really with any of this stuff. It's acceptable for now, and that's where I'll leave it. The only thing I like about it is really the port, the entrance. Let me show you. Just whack this button here. There we go. The only thing I like about it is the doors. Watching them close is very satisfying to me, but that's just because I don't really use those blocks very often, so it's just cool to see them working. Other than that, I like this area. Needs some color and needs some ships and some detail in it, but otherwise it's nice. And then also I like these small attachments that I've done to sort of bring it into the asteroid. I'm much better at designing the outside of a ship than I am the inside, and that's not even necessarily true. So what are these things here? Well, these things here are templates for holds I'm going to put in the station, and those holds will be for the production of 3 specific small ships. One builder, one, I guess, deconstructor is actually the word for that, and then I think a small attack ship. And that will be, so basically that I will have as standard 3 small ships, my builder, my deconstructor, and my small ship, my attack ship. And those things tend to get destroyed. I tend to blow them up, I tend to break them down, I tend to do stuff to them that's not very nice, and that means I regularly need updates. I mean, the amount of times I've had to cut out the destruction of that ship and rebuild it, you know, it's crazy. So here what I'll do is I'm gonna have small ships, and every time one of them breaks or I lose it or whatever, I'll just go and get another one from here, and that'll make my life a lot easier. I also think it'll look quite nice. It might maybe bring this kind of, like, I don't know, bring this image together more. And then I'll connect that using a using those maintenance tunnels, because I think they're very cool and very useful. What are we going to do about this bay? Well, it's, like I said, it's going to stay there for a while, and then I'll fix it one day in the future, and we'll make things look nicer or make things work a little bit better. But for now, it's going to stay there because I spent a long time working on it. Didn't paint in the end. Painting is always something that I put off because I never feel like I can do it well enough. I never feel like it looks proper. Like, I'm very happy with the grey, usually, even though it looks dull. And then the last thing is, I kind of want to get rid of this small area here. It's just a sort of a small pet peeve. This area doesn't do anything, it doesn't serve any purpose, and I don't even think it's connected to our station. So this could really use being taken out. Like, it's maybe nice as a little observation deck, but other than that, it's kind of pointless. So I'll probably end up chopping this place out. Ah, oxygen low, just in time for me to cut to the next section. So, I tell you what. You will see me in a second when this stuff has sort of been finished off a little bit. I don't think you'll see the inside of that thing ever again, or for a long time anyway, because I'm really unhappy with it. But this inside area I'm quite cool with, I'm quite okay with. So, okay, I will see you in a second, and we'll talk about these bays, and I'll set them up with you. So I will see you in just a second. Okay, here we are in our dock, or our little tiny bay thing, whatever you want to call it. This is inset into the asteroid, and I'm going to zoom out in a second and show you. And I rather like the way they've turned out, actually. Little tiny rooms, only big enough for one ship, really. And there's a little access port at the edge, which we'll talk about in a second. So, let me take you out so you can see from the front. Here they are, tucked into the side of our station. And I'm really happy with them. I haven't seen them with the doors closed yet. I never actually bothered closing the doors to see if it looked good. But I think they look quite nice, so I'm rather happy about them. They've also all, that was a close one, almost took my head off. They're all connected by these tubes, very dangerous tubes, because I didn't think of, for example, you know, clarifying there was a hole here or just not putting a hole here. This goes down to the bottom, all the way, probably use my jetpack to not die, and they're all the same. If I just open this up, there we go, all the same, look like this. Red and no, not red, sorry, they used to be red. I used to, the reason that this whole tunnel is red is because I painted the whole area red, and in the end I hated it, so I spent like a good 2 hours fixing it all. Like, very annoying, grinding down blocks that are covered by small corners. This tunnel leads all the way over to our observation area in the other room, and it's got an airtight seal, obviously, because I wanted the tunnel to be airtight, but I don't really know why now, because, oh, it's because this space is airtight. The reason that's airtight is because this space is supposed to be airtight. So, this is the observation room. I think we've already seen it, but I have painted it, and I've also painted that area, and I've put lights in. So, let's go have a look at that area, and then there's something else to discuss going on up there, but we'll get to that in a second. So, this is our shipbuilding area. Lovely and painted. I ended up going for sort of black and grey, which isn't really what you're supposed to do when you're painting. I think it's supposed to make things more colourful and interesting. Missed a block there. Just going to quickly paint that up. There you go. Much nicer. Black. Black. Bit of a pain in the ass because my button for doing this, my middle mouse button, is broken, so I have to sort of like push it with the force of 1,000 suns. There we go. So here's the lighting. The lighting is the thing I like most about this area, so I'm going to show you that first. It normally, obviously the sun's out, so you can't see it quite as clearly, but when the sun's not there, it casts these two lovely shadows on either side of the area, and it just gives it this very industrial feel, but it also makes it kind of, in my opinion, kind of like very daytime-ish, so that's nice. Well, yes, I rather like it. Other thing, I have finished off the wall of components, or rather the wall of blocks that contain components. Not all perfectly aligned. I didn't bother moving these ones, and these are the ones that have got the silver little lock things on the side, whereas these ones have all got the handles facing out, which is a little bit annoying, and maybe I will change in the future, because I really like the silver things. But, oh well. This is a little control area. We've seen it all before, I think. It was just not painted previously, and it works exactly the same way. There you go. I believe I've already shown you, because it's just, there's been a lot of editing and a lot of space in between each section, so I believe that I've already shown you this. It goes up to the top. I haven't shown you the top because I've changed it. I know I said, oh, you know, we'll just leave it like that, this up a bit. We'll just leave it like that until I get bored of it, and then we'll change it one day. Well, I decided to change it in this episode because it really bothered me that it was so bad, and I thought of a better idea. So, let me just show you the last thing up here. I changed that little area, and now I'm using it to hold our two brand new builder ships, and they're also the third old one. Now, originally this episode, I had intended to automate them. I think I cut out every mention of it because it's no longer possible. So the mod that, or rather the script that I was going to use to automate these is broken, and is permanently broken, as far as I know, because it's not being supported anymore. And as far as I can tell, every single auto-follow, auto-pathing script, whatever, is broken due to a change in the game recently. So I'll have to wait until that comes out, until new one comes out, because, well, I'm not capable of scripting. So, well, I'm sure I'm capable, but I'm not knowledgeable. So, I can't automate them, so they're just going to sit there for the rest of their lives, and that's okay with me. But I like this little platform. I actually think these look a little bit jammed in here, so I may end up taking them out, which will be a shame though, because I think this little platform looks cool. It just adds a little bit of something to this area, where you can like sort of mount up and look at the ships being built on this large platform, and then you come over here and you've got three building ships. I don't know, I like the way it looks. But it does feel like they're just sort of shoved here, which is a shame. So, but I like the way it changes the asteroid. I like the way it sort of melds into it. So we'll see what we do with those. But at least I've got somewhere to put them now where they can connect a little bit more reliably than this like weird appendage that I've got going on here. Okay, now this bay area. Oh, wait, no, there's also the small shipbuilding area to show you because it's kind of cool. But we had a power outage and I think it may have messed some of this stuff up. So let me see if I can fix it. So I thought I'd set this up so that when the power goes off it won't cause any problems, but apparently I didn't. Okay, problem solved. The whole thing has power. So I didn't set it up right. I've repaired it now. This place works again. So just quickly, the idea behind this place is that I can build ships in survival. I'm probably still not going to build ships in survival, but I wanted the capability to do so, and well, this is what this place is for. So this is just a small ship built into the large ship. There's a connector at the bottom that's connected. There's also a battery in here. Now there's a battery in here and a nanite control block so that it can be repaired in case I mess things up, because that was a problem before. Just need to, there you go, that wasn't painted for some reason. Lovely. Much better. Now, the light here is the only thing I really care about on this. I think it's really cool and I'm really happy with it. And it's probably the only robotic arm that I've managed to make work. So, what does it do? Well, if you hit these buttons in rapid fire, you're able to turn it left and right. And also up and down, but it's much less noticeable. But I think you might be able to see the light going up there. There you go. And then you can make it go back down as well. A little bit annoying to use. I should really put in some sort of like method of allowing it to just keep turning and then you hit the button where it's in the position you want. But I wanted to be able to have a light there so that I could, you know, see what I'm doing. I'm probably not going to ever use it, but I thought it was a cool addition anyway. Maybe I'll put a ship on there that's half built so that I can see how it works. I can't believe I forgot to put the nanite repair beacon in there, because that's kind of important. Otherwise, the ships I build on here, well, I'll have to build them myself. And that's exactly the opposite of what I wanted. So, this is the area then. I think it looks cool. I'm quite happy with it. The lighting sometimes stops working and that's a little bit weird, but otherwise I think this has got a very nice industrial feel with without being too sort of grotty, which is an English word. I'm not sure if other people have that word. Messy. So this area is good. Now, we saw the horror that was the area above and I got rid of it. I thought of a better idea and I'm just going to show you. It's a little bit off. It's to blow it all up, really, is the thing. So what I decided to do in the end, and I'm perfectly happy to repair whatever damage this does, because, well, actually, I'm perfectly happy to let the nanites repair whatever damage this does, because the problem with that bay, I realize now, is that ships don't work like that. They're not cars. You can't just park them like that. You have to have a lot of space to maneuver them and then put them back where they need to go. So I'm going to blow up this space here to have sort of like an even space. This is why I've tried to make these roughly evenly spread out. And when there's a little bit more space, I'll continue blowing up off in this direction to just make it sort of squarish. And then I'm going to put in little cubby holes. This is actually what gave me the idea, was our little pod bays out there. Oh, about the pod bays before I blow this up. So the original idea was to have them automatically building. I'm just going to play in these things for a while. Automatically building our new ships for us in case that they broke. But here's the thing. I realized those ships that I use, the ones with the like mechanical arms and stuff that I think are very cool, they can't be built automatically. They have to have someone do it. I spent hours putting them together. I can't use blueprints to build them. I can use blueprints to build the individual parts, which is actually what I do, but I can't have them automatically built entire. So those three pod bays are actually just going to be for three fighter ships, roughly of the same kind, which I will just, you know, get out and use when I need them and then leave them or blow them up or whatever. But they'll just be there whenever I need them. So, I mean, the bays are still going to be used, but they won't be used right now, and they're not really what I originally intended them to be. But still, they're going to be used, and I think, actually, the new use is cooler, because I need new fighter ships more often than I need new worker ships. So, you know, that's fine. Just letting you know about that. So, I guess there's nothing to do but blow this place up. What I've done is I've put them all, like, roughly at this spacing, a gap of three and then one new one. And I've put this here so I can remember the rough positioning of everything. Underneath these is super hard block or whatever it's called. Heavy armor plate. I don't know why I didn't know that. Heavy armor plate. And, well, the space around here will probably be okay. I'm imagining a sort of like gradual shaving off of the top bit layer here. And then I'll slowly move the size of these things up so that I can keep going. Maybe it'll mess up, maybe it'll destroy everything, but I think it'll be okay, and I'll gradually even out this space so that I can build in a better form of small ship bay. So, without further ado, let's blow this place up. And then I will see you in a second. I tell you what, I'll show you the explosion. I'm just gonna like cut through the waiting and stuff. So if I just go on here, I'm very scared of doing this because every single time I've ever done it, it's never worked quite right. There's all my warheads. I think I can arm them, and I guess I'll start the countdown of all of them actually. Yeah, here we go. Back off a little bit. Probably should have saved before that actually. So, that was pretty terrifying. Oh, buggery, you nobber. That's gonna take me hours to fix. I didn't really expect it to blow up stuff down here. I don't even know how that really happened. I thought that the explosion would just kind of be stopped. And it didn't even really even up that much up here. Well, okay, I'll repair all this mess and then we'll be back in a little while. Oh, gosh. And then I'll show you. Well, I'll probably just keep going with the explosions to clear this place up a little bit. Because there's no point me repairing the damage before I've, done all the damage. So I'm going to keep doing these explosions and hope for the best, really. Okay, here we are back again. I have made the repairs. We have lost our thing. It floated off into space. I'll have to rebuild it and reattach it, maybe in a more firm way. But I think, honestly, it coming loose because of the fact that bombs exploded all over it is fairly reasonable, and I would even say fairly well designed, given that it was only hurt a little bit by a giant explosion. So I have to put that back in. That's fine. I'll have to rebuild the bloody arm thing as well. That's also fine. So here's what I've done. More warheads. I just off camera blew up a little bit more of this corner, which was another 10 minutes of repairing. And well, this is the most I'm willing to do. I feel like any more of this would start cutting into this space around here. I mean, it's quite thick, and I suspect I can go quite far back. I'm gonna set these off again, and then we're gonna survey the damage, and then I'll probably stop there. It depends really if we've got enough space. You see, what we need is, I mean, roughly the around, I guess 4 blocks for each one. So let's say the first ones are on the floor. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we need one block in between. And these are, by the way, for the little cubby holes. One block in between, or let's say maybe 2 blocks. Yeah, 2 blocks in between. So there's the 4 for the base, 2 blocks. So then this will be the new one. I'll just put that there to indicate. This will be the new one. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then there'll be another one here. There you go. And then there would be the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that would mean roughly 3. 2 on that side, 6. 2 on that side, 12. And then I guess probably 2 there and 2 there, because the elevator's got to go in the middle as well. Which, by the way, I haven't talked about. This is where I'd like to put the elevator in the end. This long line symbolizes where I also need to blow up the wall here. Probably not going to do it in this episode, I think. But this long line symbolizes where the elevator's got to go, and I've got to blow it up all the way down to the bottom. So first thing to do is to actually get rid of this, because it'll get in the way of the blowing up stuff. I should have cut it down before it started building, really. Give me a second. There we go, all cleared up. I think the plates will probably cause issues as well. So, what have I done this time that's different that'll hopefully make the damage a little bit better? Well, I turned the gravity off. I think last time things went flying all the way down there and did a lot of damage because gravity made them very, very dangerous. But I think in this case now, things will go a lot better. Or I hope anyway. So let's just go through with it, because if we don't, it'll just get worse and worse and worse. So there's all the warheads that it should be. Let's arm them and start the countdown, and then we'll get far away, and I'll turn off my HUD so that we can see. Okay, wow, that is unfortunate, but nowhere near as much damage as previous events. You know what, it didn't actually go that high up. I was expecting a lot more up and a lot less sideways. Maybe I have to do it again for the sake of getting a little bit more height. I'm not sure about that. I mean, I'm already starting to worry about how close this must be to the edge. Yeah, we've already cleared a little bit of an extra hole. Well, let's reconnect this, because actually this being broken, should probably turn my HUD on. This being broken means that there's no connection between the top and bottom. There we go, and now the nanites should have power. That small bit of lag indicating the station is reattaching. Because really, this is just completely separated from all the rest of the station. So we should see all of this powering up now, or well, having already been powered up. And now we can expect the nanites coming through. So what am I going to do? I'm going to spend some time cleaning this up. It's a little bit unfortunate how much it's gone outwards, because we didn't need more outer space. We needed more upward space. So maybe there'll have to be more blowing up. Yes, I should use a drill to do this, because it would be a lot more like resource efficient. But on the other hand, I don't really care. I mean, I can get iron from anywhere else, so it's not that big of a deal to have to pass a bunch of time, you know, finding more iron in different places, because I've wasted all the iron of this place. All right, despite the fact that it's a little bit less high than I wanted, it's become a big enough room that it can be like effective. So I'm going to call this here. I'm not going to keep blowing everything up. What is that? Oh, it's a piece of scrap metal. I'm not going to keep blowing everything up. I'm going to do the final repairs, and then we're going to start building in the bays, which is a little bit more troublesome because they have to be a certain shape and size. So I have to cut in with my drill, which is fine. And then there's already actually a pretty solid circle around this. It's just really the lower layers that I'm gonna have to blow up, but I'm gonna have to do that with small ship bombs, because small ship warheads, because the large ship ones make too large of a hole. Like, we don't need a hole this large. We need a hole well, about the same size as this little dent here. So we'll have to change that, but we will sort that out in a second after I fix this place up and we've got it looking like it could theoretically become a bay. So I will see you in a second. Okay, so here's all the damage cleaned up. I'm actually put in the floor again properly and cut a hole for the sake of a future elevator that I think probably won't be in this episode. Or maybe, because I'm really tempted to get this whole place finished so I can move on, because I'm getting sick of seeing this part of the asteroid. I want to see another part of the asteroid. So it's going to get even worse because there's a lot of work in front of me. So this is a template. I've put these two lights in so you can see, by the way, because it's quite dark in here. This is a template of where the bays are going to go. They're not in their final position. They're in the position that allows me to see where they need to be. So, for example, I've left in between each of these one block's worth of space so that when I put them in, you can see the asteroid in between them, which will be more attractive, basically. I'm not going to give each one of them doors, which makes my life a lot simpler. They're just going to be open bays. All they really need is a way of getting in and out, and that's, you know, the hole at the front. And also a way for people to get in and out of them, which isn't strictly speaking necessary, but is kind of important to me and my stupid role-playing sort of thing that I do sometimes. So, this is the only, this base and I think these places up here, I'm almost certain there's not enough width. If I show you out here, like, this is the edge of our station and there's not a lot of thickness in here, and I believe that this box here, well, there you go, you can already see the edge here is this. Yeah, this looks like one of my bays, and if I take out the steel or the iron all the way to here, it'll probably crack through. So I'm not sure about the positioning of all of these bays, but they're probably roughly correct. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dig into the back, move the sort of framework so that there's the same, you know, the same distance. I think this is 5x4. There's a 5x4 hole here. Chisel out all of the stone, which is going to be a pain in the bum because, well, I can't use the big explosive, and I think the small explosive might be okay. I'm going to try out on a couple, and if it works, that'll be fine. And if it doesn't work, I'll just cover it up with the steel plates, or with the blocks rather. So we'll see what we end up doing, but the most important thing is just to sort of start, because it's going to be the same mindless work again. I've got to chisel out all these, put in the iron block to hide all the mess I make chiseling it out, and then keep going and do all of them. But once we get there, it'll be worth it. So I'm hoping to cut in somewhere through so that I can show you the progress, because it's going to be like a long work and it's going to be a huge jump as well. So hopefully we can go in there somewhere in the middle and we can have a look at what's changed. I need to fix this door because these are all set to close and these are new. I had to replace them. Otherwise, there's going to be this permanent hole and they'll always be out of sync, but that's just a button to tick. And then, well, that's basically it. So I guess I will see you in just a little second when I've finished putting these all in their places. And we'll continue on from there. Okay, this is finished, or at least this is close enough to finish that I can show you. They've all been moved back, all the templates, what I had before, the little squares things that I had, have been moved back roughly into the same position they were, but just, you know, dug into the wall so that... try not to kill yourself, so that there's not as much, so there's enough space to put a ship there, and but they're all arranged properly, so there should be, apart from here where I messed up, a one block space between all of them. Here I messed up, and I don't know how it happened really, maybe I built them wrongly, I left no space in between, so what I'm going to try and do is make it look like the space in between by, because all of these outside blocks are going to be changed so they fade into the wall a bit, like if I go back and show you other bays. There you go, didn't kill myself that time. So these ones here, you'll notice, they sort of like slide into the wall. They've got angle blocks all around them, which makes them just sort of merge a little bit better. So what I'm going to do is angle all of the sides of these bays too. And that'll just make them look a lot smoother, a lot more like hidden, but a lot more like merged with the asteroid, actually, is the best way of saying it. Because my big thing on this ship, oh my god, nothing at all happened there. So anyway, as I was saying, the big thing about this station that I really want, and it's important to me, is that the asteroid and the station seem like they're sort of part of each other. They've been built into each other together. So that's what I'll try and do. I'll try and smooth out all these corners so that the metal merges into the asteroid. And that's what I've also done here. I've tried to pull away the door as much as possible from the asteroid. And this is much better than it was before, for everything actually, because it's not like I'm trying to build a station in an asteroid. It's like I'm trying to turn an asteroid into a station, if the difference between those things makes sense. I mean that I want it to look like I've taken the asteroid and fitted a station inside of it, rather than sort of building a station and then trying to shove it inside an asteroid. I think I'm just confusing my metaphors a bit more. In this case, I've had to rely on the sort of curvature of the asteroid to define, apart from that I blew it up a bit, to define where my bays were going. And previously, I just sort of built a square and then tried and started shoving stuff in there. This is much better and I prefer it, if as a summary. So, what is left to do now? Well, one, I think I am going to blow up the space between here and here and just sort of put the chassis of the lift in. Maybe that's not the right word, the filling of the lift. And that's not even better. You know what? The outside bit of the lift. Filling was definitely not the right word. That would be the inside. And put the inside bit of the lift in just so that we can see how it looks. And then also, and I'll cut to that. I'll show you that me doing that because it's kind of cool blowing stuff up. I'm going to try... I think I'll use like a small ship with a 6x6 block of bombs to get the right size. I'll have to do some testing, maybe in a creative world, just to see how much is blown up by that. So... we'll see, but I'll try my best to show you it because I think it's important. So, the other thing is to, like I said, take these corners and turn them into, like, merge them more gently into the asteroid. One thing to mention, I went through a little bit. I really, over there, I was really careful. I did my best not to puncture the asteroid, even though in some places it is a little bit rough. I did my best not to, like, drill through to the edge. Here, I kind of, like, I made the hole and then regretted it, and so I decided just to bring them through. So, when we eventually continue and sort of merge this area to this one here, this will be a walkway. There'll be a walkway going along here. And I'm happy with that, actually. It's, you know, sometimes the design of your ship comes out a bit organically. Like, this area is this shape because that's the shape of the asteroid. This area here is that shape because I had to fit it in the middle. So, and I much prefer this area, for example, to this area, or down here to this area, because it's much more organic to the nature of the asteroid. I'm starting to sound like an asteroid weirdo. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, let's just cut over to when this is done, and then we'll do some blowing up. So yes, I will see you in a second when this is smoothly merged into the asteroid. Oh, also I fixed this bit here, which was causing problems. So we have power again, although not permanent power. I realize we're running out of power, so I think next week we're going to have to do a little bit of like solar power stuff, because I'm beginning to worry about our supplies of uranium. So, I will see you in a second when this is done. Okay, here we are with our bays, all sort of like molded in there. Like I said, I'm happy with them, I think. We'll talk about this thing in a second. I'm happy with them, I think. I ended up sort of like doing my best to not make them all the same, but rather sort of like have them flow together. So here, they're all sort of pointing towards the middle one to sort of follow the curve of the asteroid, which worked out quite well in some places and bad in other places. Like this one is quite ugly and probably needs to be changed. But these ones, if you look at just this corner, or just this bit and pretend this one doesn't exist, looks quite nice. And I did the same thing over here. Here you can see they've all sort of been just smoothed out a little bit. Nothing yet coloured. Things will be coloured. Now, the other thing I did is actually that I've had for a long time installed the mod for concrete, for the voxel concrete you can use. And I really like this mod, I just haven't had an opportunity to use it. So here I've got one, here I've used it, and I've sort of used it like a bit of glue. Everywhere that I made a hole while building, and, well, here I need to clean this up actually, I'll do it now. Everywhere I made a hole with glue, building, I sort of used this to glue the things back together, and then I used a very rubbishy version of my drill, so that I didn't like destroy it all, and sort of tried to smooth it out. And in weather stone, it looks quite good. Over the iron, it looks kind of, I don't know, kind of weird, kind of not very nice. But over the stone, I actually really like the effect, and I think I'll use it a lot more, because I'm a really big fan of the concept. So, there you go, there's that. I've put those in. The bays are all roughly the same. Like I said, non-painted, none of them have been lit. And I think that's what I'm going to do next after what's coming over there. But there's, I think these two are not connected, I've checked. They're just not on the system. Again, be careful about killing yourself. They're just not connected to the system. And then the other thing I've done is I've just sort of fixed up this area a bit. The front door, the port, whatever you want to call it, now sort of blends more effectively into the wall. And I'm actually a big fan of this. This, I think, looks much better than it is before. The whole thing looks much better than it did before. All it really needs is lighting and painting. Whoops, don't get that close to the mines. Lighting and painting, like I said, and I think it'll be pretty nice. So, what about the mines? Well, this is for the elevator. I decided I want to do it in this episode. Okay. I decided I want to do it in this episode. So, I'm just going to be very careful about where I'm backing into. So, I built this contraption in Creative and had it built here. Bit of a pain in the bum because the projectors are not building projections. No, sorry, the nanites aren't building projections, which is rather annoying. So I had to sort of like place it manually and then gradually, you know, with my welding ship, create each block, and then the nanites were able to do it. But still a bit of a pain in the bum. But we're really running low on resources, which is the other problem. I've been like sort of grabbing new stuff as we needed it, but it's not really the most useful thing. That's why our mining ship is off in the distance doing stuff. But it's not the most useful thing, so I think next episode we're going to have to do a little bit of like catching up with ourselves. So, first though, let's talk about the explosions. What I'm going to do is, this is for building the elevator shaft. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to blow up here, like all the way down here, and then in the exact same place, which is the benefit of this system, I'll explain in a second, I can just put it back in the exact same place and continue going down, down, down until we get to somewhere, I guess about here. Yeah, I'd like that. So, how does this thing work? Firstly, it's covered in mines, which is great. The idea was to have a consistent explosion. It's not that consistent because if you look here, I think it's hard to see, but it's off center. There it is. Yeah, it's not quite centered here. I didn't put it together very well in Creative, but oh well. So the idea was to have a consistent explosion that will create a consistent tunnel. And this has been quite effective so far on the test. And the nanite's there just to be able to repair it and theoretically to build it, but that didn't work out quite so well. So I'm going to set this off, and what I've done is, if I just click here, there you go, you've got a little me there off in the distance, and this is, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to build this, and then cut between all the explosions, so that you don't have to watch me building this over and over again, because I really have to build it, move it down, build it, move it down, build it, move it down, which is going to be very laborious and take a very long time. So what I'm going to do is build it and then cut to the explosion, build it and cut to the explosion, build it and cut to the explosion, so that we can just get along with making the elevator shaft. I will not be building the elevator, just the elevator shaft, because the elevator is going to be a pain in the bum as well. But at least to have the shaft there, that will be good enough. I'm really trying hard to get myself on camera. Oh, nope, where am I? Oh, there I go. Well, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this off now. And we'll cut back to this perspective so that I can start off the whole process. I think it's going to be a really cool effect, actually. I'm quite excited. So I will see you in just a second. I should have put the hand-waving animation on here so that I could say hello properly. Okay, well, I'm going to go set off the explosion. I'll have to switch back to my normal camera view because there's no way I'm ever going to be able to do it like this. And we will watch it happen. Okay, so here is the giant hole that we've blown up. It's pretty effective as holes go. So in the end, I kind of cut out a tiny bit of the explosion because I spent a long time rebuilding this thing to its full size. And you may have seen that in the, maybe it cut through, skipped a little bit of the hole. I've spent a long time building this through to its whole size, building the explosions all the way down. And then I kind of realized, what's the point? I only need to blow out the bottom. So after a certain point, I just started putting a new level on the bottom, which was actually a lot more resource efficient and a lot more, you know, less time consuming as well. So that's why the hole is no longer consistent. So a part of the reason why I wanted to build it all at the same time, like continuously have exactly the same explosion going off, extending this sort of like divot which is created, was, well, to have it even, to have it nice looking. But in the end, it still looks pretty nice. I mean, it's no longer quite as attractive as I probably would have liked it to be, but it's still pretty attractive. I mean, you know, chiseled rock is chiseled rock. So that's what we've got. Now, the hole is done. I'm going to go ahead and put the elevator shaft in. I think I'll do some other touches just to sort of make this area finished so it's like nice and settled in. And I also like to sort of do the indications for where it's going to be integrated into the rest of our base. So like, I think there's going to be another couple layers up here, past the ceiling of this bay area, probably here and here, just before the reactor area. So I'm going to put in some sort of indications to where those are going to go, just so we can start sort of building it into our base and see where things are going to go. I mean, we've already got a pretty good indication with this bay here of the fact that there's going to be a continuation around here. So it's going to be roughly this level where we're going to have the next layer of our base, the next sort of area in this sort of explosion crater thing. So I'm going to get a start on putting those in, and I'm going to do the finishing touches of this bay area, probably put some lighting in, some color in, you know, make it look a little bit nicer, make everything working, find somewhere to put an office, because this place, or not an office, but kind of like a tower, but not in a tower, rather in a box. That's why I say office. Somewhere to put in a little place for a controller to be, so that they can keep an eye on all the ships coming in and out. You know, make things all scheduled, make sure they take the taxes for docking your spaceship and stuff like that. So I'm getting a bit creepy here with my roleplay. So let's just go ahead and build that stuff, and I'll see you in a second when things are sort of built in, and then we'll have to say goodbye because this has been a long episode. I will see you in a second when we have a cool elevator right here. Okay, here we are. Look at this. That's a weird way of starting it, sorry. Well, I've put it in the elevator shaft. Rather happy with it, actually. I started thinking, like, too much glass, maybe. But in the end, I think it looks really cool. Not designed around any concept of elevator, because my efforts to make things like elevators work have almost always been unsuccessful. But don't know why I turned my little dumbness off, that was a very bad idea. But, you know, it looks quite nice, and maybe I'll just leave it there until the game puts something in that'll make my life easier in terms of making elevators. I've also put in these sort of, like, level indicators, so we're going to get in, maybe squeeze in is the better word, two extra layers here. One, this will be the layer that should be, or if not, is almost the same layer as this here. Maybe it'll step up a little bit. The one that sort of curves around. And I think actually this, and that's you know, going to be the one that's sort of this base, the same base layer that goes around here and goes all the way to here. And maybe there's, you know, it's going to be sort of a cool, relaxed area, kind of for civilians or people visiting, you know, whatever. And then this layer here is actually more about connecting to the inner ring, which will be eventually, should be roughly lined up with here, which will eventually span this sort of center area of the asteroid, filling in this space around here, and also closing off the reactor area from any sort of attack type thing. Not that we're going to get any of those, because that's never going to happen. Next thing I have added is this little tiny room here. Should be airtight. There you go. Got gravity. Should be airtight. This is going to be the control room, like I talked about. Well, I think I called it an office. It is kind of boxy, but I love the view it's got here. If you look over and have a look at the oh gosh, there's no gravity here. If you have a look at the bay, you can sort of see out over to the other ships. Very disorientating this. I'm going to turn my jetpack on and align myself properly. And I also like the way that the room shapes here to the glass. Now, I'm pretty sure this room is airtight. This is a worrying gap, but I think, nonetheless, this gap is not big enough for air. Air in this game is very thick, and I'm pretty sure that it's too thick to get through that gap. So this is, you know, kind of an underwhelming office. There's really not enough in here to make it look like an office. So as I sort of equip the station, I'm going to try and make these places a little bit more interesting, especially when I start using things like mods for interior furniture. I'll put more work into making rooms like this a little bit more unique, because right now it's just sort of a grey block, although I do love the architecture of the room. Not that it was intentional, I just had to fit it to that side. So, it's kind of squeezed in here, but I like it. And then in order to, oh, bloody hell. And then in order to get things to sort of, like, blend into each other, I've used this form as sort of the pattern for just doing a few, like, sort of suspension bars, let's call them, like, little pieces of metal to hold up the place. But really, they just look good. And that's the same on the other side. They should be aligned. There's bars on the other side that continue. And it just sort of draws together the different areas, which I kind of like. And I've kind of tried to move it into the bay as well next to it. So I'm not sure how I feel about it. The bays all seem a little bit off to me. They don't seem quite right. I'm not really sure why, so maybe I'll have to keep working on those. I've put in a color on every single backboard of each bay. And that color is just, you know, the top layer is yellow, the second layer is blue, and the bottom layer is red. And that is for the sake of later on organizing what ships go in what bays. Not that I'm ever going to need to do that, because we'll never have any visiting ships. Although I'm thinking of just capturing ships and putting them in these bays to make it look like they're full. Although only ships that will fit in these bays, obviously. I also put in this, like, well, it's the same kind of thing as this metal here. It's just sort of to look good, but it also looks like structural support, or maybe there's some cables running through there. You know, it makes things kind of look better. So that's in there, and then what you keep seeing flickering is the lights. So I've dug into the wall and stuck in a light. If I just show you through here, there you go. The light is connected through this. One side of this has a block still continuing up, and then I sealed up the holes I made with, or as much as possible, I sealed up the holes I made with the concrete. And then we've got just sort of like it sort of slips into the ceiling, which I really like. And then these two are connected by this sort of what's it called? I can't remember what this stuff is called. Interior pillar. There you go. And that goes all the way along here, and then it connects. These two lights connect to the main system through an interior pillar that goes under the ground to this block, or under the ceiling to this block. And then I fixed in the hole again with the concrete. I love the concrete. It's been so long since I ever used it, and I really, really like the way it works. So it's a really great addition to the game. So I mean, this is the bay. I've also colored in just this area here. Not that significant, but it just sort of brightens up the place a little bit. The light flashing is really annoying, and I didn't want this effect. I wanted, if I go down to the ground, you'll be able to see it. I wanted this effect, slightly patterned light that you can sort of see. Maybe I should just take the grills off, because you actually can't see them much. I wanted sort of very diffused light, but only in the center. And then I was going to put lights in the bays, but actually it was so much effort and it seemed so unhelpful. Like, it didn't really make much of a difference to how well they were lit, so I ended up not putting any lights in the bays. Maybe that's a mistake, but we'll see. And then also I have continued the elevator all the way down to this space here, where we have our ship bay. So it looks quite kind of nice now, the way this sort of smooths into it. I'm thinking that I may chisel out the wall here a little bit and have a little space here, maybe a med bay or something like that, that curves off around here. Because there's not really much point in having this wall here. We've already got a lot of asteroids showing, which is kind of nice. Like, it has a really attractive effect. But it would also be nice, equally nice, to have the asteroids stop here, keep this wall in, and then smooth it round and put in something here. You know, just sort of bring everything together, because this section looks very cut off from this section for now. And is literally cut off from that section. And also we need a way of descending from here to here, which I guess I'll work on in the next episode. Other than that, I fixed this small area. This is now back. Realized that I didn't build this large enough. There's quite a large gap in here. I've put it back. It should be fully connected. And I've made the light work again, which is nice. Look at that. Very attractive. Big fan of that. And well, I'm really happy actually with how this has worked out. Now, a quick mistake that I should show you that is quite unfortunate, and I'm really starting to hate these goddamn things. They are just the wrong size in every sense. I should have planned this better. They are just the wrong size in every sense for their ports to actually work. They're one block too wide this way to have these bays, and they're one block too low on this side, you know, in this dimension, height-wise, in order to have two layers of these bays close the doors. So, not really sure what to do about that. I'll probably end up having to use a mod to have slightly longer bay doors. We will see. But, well, I am okay with the progress we've made. In fact, I'm rather happy about it. I tell you what, let's open the bay door so we can get a look of how things look in the... yeah, that's what I said. Get a look of how things look. Get a look at how things are, you know, when we have the doors open. There we go. Let's go around here. Ooh, wow, bonked my head a bit there. Even have a look as they open. I think that looks pretty cool, actually. I think that's a really effective looking... Yeah, I like that. Needs more colour. It really does need more, not colour necessarily, but texture actually. More things going on in there. But that's fine. I have some ideas about how to continue going, but I think we'll have to leave it here for now. Oh, this structure here is just to connect that asteroid to this section of the area to this section, because I kept blowing up stuff over here and deconnecting it. So I figured I should put something outside where it's safe. But this will be gone soon, because it's now fully connected using the elevator, which is equally fine. Anyway, I think we're going to have to leave it here, just because, you know, we've done a lot this episode. It's all been in this area. It's not been that exciting. Well, maybe that's your business, but I haven't found it that exciting myself. It was just a lot of stuff to do. But it was still fun stuff, and I'm still really happy with the change we made to our base. It actually looks like a completely new base with these changes. I might fly out and just show you as well, because I never got around to doing it. How nice this stuff looks from far away. Like, it looks like a really cool base, doesn't it? Or at least I think it looks like a cool base, but then again, I am the one that built it. So, you know, it's fairly reasonable that I think it's cool. But, I don't know, it just looks very spacey. Which I guess it could not look spacey. Oh well, I tell you what, as we're flying in, I'll just say goodbye. So I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment below if you've got any ideas, questions or suggestions. Hopefully there will not be as big of a gap between this episode and the next, but you never know. So thank you for those who have been patient. And anyway, I will see you next time.